a far ring.
Mm-hmm.
Took out an enemy.
Got a buddy jumping in Atlanta like I'm Donald Glover. I don't want no good girl, I'm thinking I need a freak bitch. I don't want no good girl cause your boy ain't no lover. If I run in you, fuck her with no rubber, then I...
How you guys doing today? Tips and Allen, they hear y'all. And in this video, we are talking about an update we got on the Iron Crown event. Let's do it. Y'all doing like I always say, I appreciate every single one of y'all stop my videos. Y'all just aren't subscribers. If you have our family, and I appreciate it and I love y'all. And if you are new to my channel, please make sure to subscribe and like. Also, social media will be down below, baby girl. Let's do it. All right then, y'all. So I'm going to be reading straight from the update that we got. And like I always have it, I will have a link to this page in the description down below. And it says, hey, everyone, at launch, we made a promise to players that we intend to do monetization in a way that felt fair and provided choice to players on how they spent their money and time. A core decision during development of Apex Legends was that we wanted to make a world-class battle royale game and quality, depth, progression, and importance for today's conversation, how we sell stuff. With the Iron Crown event, we missed the mark when we broke our promise by making Apex packs the only way to get what many consider to be the coolest skins we've released. And you know, y'all, this is, of course, is from all the disappointment and from all the hate that they've been receiving lately, and rightfully so, right? Because, you know, when we saw all these skins being leaked and everything, when they finally announced this Iron Crown event, everyone was extremely excited for what was to come in Apex Legends and how this event looked amazing and the skins looked even better, the Bloodhound heirloom and, you know, everything that came with it. And, you know, to download it and then finally realize that you have to pay over $200 to $300 just to get everything is ridiculous. So I'm happy that they did, you know, finally say something about this. But it continues to say, we've heard you and have spent a lot of time discussing the feedback and how to structure events in the future, as well as changes that we will make to Iron Crown. To get right into it, here are the changes we are making. Starting 8/20, we'll be adding and rotating all 12 of the event exclusive legendary items to the store over the course of the final week of the event for the regular legendary skin cost of 1800 Apex coins. You'll still be able to purchase Iron Crown Apex packs for 700 Apex coins if you choose. The store schedule for the week will be as follows, and I'll put a picture up right now of everything. So it looks like Tuesday through Thursday, we're gonna have the Pathfinder, Lifeline, Wraith, Watson, and Alternator skin. Thursday through Sunday, we're gonna have the Gibraltar Mirage, Bloodhound, R99, RA45 skins. And Sunday through Tuesday, Peacekeeper, G7, Pathfinder, Lifeline, and Wraith skins. So once again, so, you know, it's the whole thing, y'all. This is really good. I'm liking that they're actually doing this, because, you know, we really do need this. This is for future collection events. We'll provide more ways to obtain items than just buying Apex packs. A couple other things I would like to address. We'll need to be better at letting our players know what to expect from the various event structures in Apex Legends. Over the last 6 months, we've been learning a lot about operating a live service free-to-play game. One of the takeaways from this week, beyond what was mentioned above, is that our messaging for expectations need to be clearer. This is a different event structure than the Legendary Hunt from Season 1, and will be different from planned future upcoming events. We're learning more each day on what works, what doesn't, and how to provide the best possible experiences and content to all of you. With Apex Legends, it is very important for us to know that we don't sell a competitive advantage. Our goal has not been to squeeze every last dime out of our players, and we have structured the game so that all players benefit from those who choose to spend money. Events like Legendary Hunt, Iron Crown exist so that we can continue to invest in creating more free content for all players. This week has been a huge learning experience for us, and we're taking lessons forward to continue bringing you the best possible experience. Thanks again for being a part of the Apex Legends community. We look forward to continuing to release awesome new stuff for everyone to enjoy. So, y'all, quick recap, you know, I'm extremely happy that they're doing this. Like they said, starting 8/20, they'll be rotating everything into the store and you'll be able to get it. And, you know, y'all, I'm really happy that they announced this, because it was ridiculous that when, you know, you went to the store and you looked at all those crazy prices and everything, it was like, wow, you know, there's no way that I can actually get this. I'd have to grind and just pray that I got a skin. I was able to get the Bloodhound skin when I was able to get my first Iron Crown pack. I got extremely lucky with that, y'all. But, I mean, look at everything else, you know. And just look at the amount you would have to pay. I mean, you're looking upwards towards, I'm pretty sure people say between the $200 to $500 range if you wanted to get absolutely everything, y'all. I mean, that is absolutely ridiculous, and I'm happy that they announced this. And, you know, I can't wait to see you know, everyone being able to unlock stuff and get things when this starts going into rotation on the 20th. And let me know what y'all think, man. Let me know what y'all think of this update. What is your favorite thing on the Iron Crown event? Do you like in solo mode? Are you have you gotten anything you want? What is it that you want? And let me know about all that in the comments below, and I'll catch you on the next one. Tips on 918 is out of here.
Yamagini chain, rest in peace to my superior. Hermes link a feeder village in Liberia. TMZ taking pictures causing my hysteria.